you how to solve a one-variable equation, whether it be a linear equation, a quadratic equation, an equation with degree of 3, whatever you like. I want to learn how to solve a one-variable equation, both graphically and just telling the calculator to solve this algebra equation. Now, of course, we are not really solving the equation, the calculator is, but this will be a nice way to check your algebraic work that you show your teacher. So, we're going to use the scratch pad just to do this as quickly as possible. So with this middle of this left side of the calculator here, we're going to toggle between the calculator scratch pad here and the graphing scratch pad. And let's do the graphical solution first. So we're going to select the show entry line. We're going to have, and its mind's cleared out, so we're going to type in 2x squared. So 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. Okay, so this is effectively y equals 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. And hit enter for graph, and voila, there's our equation. Now, a solution is an x-intercept, it is a root. So any place the graph crosses the x-axis is a solution. So thus, we're finding x-intercepts, we're letting y equal 0 and find those solutions. So graphically, what we're going to do is hit menu, select analyze graph, go over and choose 0, and a 0, a root, a solution are all the same, they're all x-intercepts, and as you can see here it's saying lower bound. So your finger would be on the touchpad here, I'm using my computer's touchpad. You're going to put the cursor to the left of the x-intercept you would like, or 0, click the center of the touchpad, so voila, now it asks for upper bound. So move the line to the right, you know your x values are getting bigger, so this is an upper bound. You can see it's already highlighting the x-intercept, the 0, so select or click the center of your touchpad again, and voila, there's our x-intercept. Now, if that's in the way and you'd like it to be easier to read, you can put your cursor over, again with the touchpad, put your cursor over, your hand over that coordinate, click the center of the touchpad and hold it, your hand will close, and then you can move that coordinate around anywhere you like so it's easier to read. So that point is 0.50. Or coordinate is 0.50. There's two interception points, there's two solutions. So again, if you want to find an x-intercept, a solution, a 0, a root, you hit menu, analyze graph, choose 0. Again, lower bound, put that line to the left of the root or 0 you'd like, the solution you'd like. Select it, go to the right, select again, and your other x-intercept, your other root, your other 0 is 2, 0. Now, I did say this is only going to be for finding solutions, but if you hit menu again and analyze graph, you'll notice that one of the choices, you can do a lot of things. You find the minimum of a graph, a maximum, intersection if you have two graphs on the window at the same time, inflection points, that's a calculus idea, and so on. Well, a parabola, oh, this parabola here, let me hit escape, this parabola is opening up, so there is a minimum value. So a little bonus here. Menu, analyze graph, let's find the minimum, and once again, put that line to the left of the value that you want, the lower bound, the x values. Where are they smaller? Well, that's to the left of the minimum. Hit enter. That's to the right of the minimum. Now when I say enter, I'm talking about the center of the touchpad. Click the center again, and voila, there's the minimum of the parabola, which we know is that if it's the bottom of the parabola, we're talking about the vertex, which is a key component that we'd like to know, you know, about that parabola. Okay, so what if you want to solve this algebraically? Well, we're going to toggle over to the calculator scratch pad, and you hit menu, and you have many, many choices. This thing is amazing how much this calculator does. We're going to choose algebra. You can see that you can put in an expression and have it factored. You can expand. You can find zeros. We're going to solve an equation. Again, we're going to try and solve this equation of 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. So I'm going to put in 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. And now I have to type in that I'm actually setting it to equal to 0. So equals 0. Now what would you like to solve for? Clearly, there's only one variable, so we're looking for x, but you have to tell the calculator that. So we're going to do, this is the equation we want to solve, and we're going to do comma, and then tell it what variable we'd like to solve for. Clearly, that is an x. So comma x, hit enter, and voila, there's your x-intercept that we just found graphically of 1/2 and 2. So there you go. That's how you find the solutions of a one-variable equation, both graphically and if you want to call this algebraically with our graphing calculator. Now, you did not really solve this. The calculator did. So, as I always say, this is Mr. True. Go actually do the solution. Go do your homework. Thank you very much. Bam!